Okay, the final item of business this evening is a member's business debate on motion 120000 in the name of Keith Brown on congratulating the University of Stirling on the launch of its Winning Students 100 programme. The debate will be concluded without any questions being put. I'd invite members wishing to participate to press the request to speak buttons and invite Keith Brown to open the debate around 7 minutes. Mr Brown.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and thank you also to those members who signed this motion allowing it to be debated today. I brought the debate to Parliament today to celebrate a significant milestone for the University of Stirling, which is located in my constituency. And that milestone is the launch of the Winning Students 100 programme, a successor programme to the existing Winning Students programme, which supports athletes to balance the needs of their studies and the demands of competing in high-performance sport. The University of Stirling has been Scotland's University for Sporting Excellence since 2008, around the same time that the initial Winning Students programme was launched. And since then, the programme has supported over 1,700 scholarships, providing crucial assistance to gold medal Olympians, Paralympians and European and world champions, including Scottish long-distance runners Laura Muir and Ailish McCaughan, and, of course, Alwa's own Olympic medal-winning swimmer Duncan Scott. The new Winning Students 100 programme is the latest development in that proud history, which will support 106 students in its inaugural year, including Olympic gold medalist curler Hayley Duff, Commonwealth Games gold medalist diver Grace Reid, and the under-23s European 10,000 metres track record holder Megan Keith, among others, and not least Lewis Stewart, Commonwealth Games 2022 gold medalist and Paralympic 2020 silver medalist, and Callum Douglas, Scottish hockey men's player and GB under-23 champion, both of whom I believe are currently sat in the public gallery with members of staff from the university who are involved in supporting the Winning Students 100 programme. And with your indulgence, Presiding Officer, I think it would be good if the members of the Parliament present would show their appreciation for the efforts of the staff and the students here. The scholarship includes up to £3,000 in funding, academic flexibility for athletes and a hardship fund to provide additional support to athletes if it's needed. And the University of Stirling has brought together a network of 28 sports institutions and 21 education institutions to support the delivery of this programme. And over the past 15 years, both Winning Students programmes have supported these exceptional individuals through their studies, also allowing them to dedicate themselves to their respective sports. The commendation for the success of these programmes, however, goes far beyond just the University of Stirling. The initiative receives funding from the Scottish Funding Council and from Sports Scotland, along with other support from the tertiary education sector, and that needs to be highlighted and commended as well. But programmes like these require a great deal of organisation and logistical management in the background. And the University of Stirling has been exemplary in its management and delivery of the Winning Students 100 programme, supported by an experienced advisory board and management group, comprising of professionals from both the sports and education sectors, to ensure that the programme operates with extremely high standards. I think it takes just a little imagination to realise how much the pressures of competing in high-performance sports can put on somebody trying to, at the same time, complete their studies. And I think they deserve remarkable praise for what they've done. And I remember attending a reception at the University of Stirling with a number of the swimming champions. This is about 3 or 4 years ago. And at that time, the University of Stirling had more medals than many countries had at the previous championships, which just shows that there's something in the air at the University of Stirling which has led to this astonishing success. Indeed, a member was just saying that to me just now. What is it about Stirling and the surrounding area that seems to be so productive in terms of producing some world-class athletes? But as I say, I think it's not just what they've achieved in terms of sport, but also the fact that they've done that at the same time as undertaking some intensive studying as well, which deserves our praise. And I don't wish to take up the full 7 minutes, Presiding Officer, but just to conclude, the University of Stirling is the jewel in the crown of Scotland's sporting excellence and has rightly been recognised as such since the Winning Students programme, which, as I mentioned, launched in 2008-09, supporting some of Scotland's top athletes behind the scenes since then. And it's through these athletes that the Winning Students 100 programme will continue to elevate our sporting excellence as a country. And I would want to wish them all the best in their studies, all the best in their sports, and also all the best to the University of Stirling, a remarkable institution which I'm very proud to represent, and wish it every success in the pursuit of that goal in the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Brown. We move to the open debate. I now call Alexander Stewart to be followed by Kenneth Gibson. Around 4 minutes, Mr. Stewart.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'd like to thank Keith Brown for bringing this important debate to the Chamber this evening, welcoming the launch of the Winning Students 100 programme. Scotland has long been a nation that has punched above its weight when it comes to sporting success. As well as the rich pool of sporting talent Scotland enjoys, this success has been due in no small part to the support that athletes have received throughout their careers, and Stirling University needs to be commended and congratulated on its achievements. For example, this is, if we look at individuals who have come from previous students' programme, which was launched back in 2008 and was funded by the Scottish Funding Council. Some of these athletes supported in the programme are now Olympic medalists, as you've heard already, and household names like Lorna Muir and Duncan Scott. The years that athletes spend at university are an important opportunity for them to take part in their sport and take it to the next level. These athletes face the challenges of combining their studies with their training and competitive programmes and going forward, and that balance needs to be struck. And the winning students are provided and can receive grants up to £3,000, as we've heard already. However, the programme also provides much needed academic flexibility for students, which allow them to train to the very best of their ability, Presiding Officer. The new Winning Students programme has already awarded 106 scholarships for 28 different sports, including athletics, fencing, diving, hockey, rowing and triathlon. As Scotland's University of Sport Excellence, it is only appropriate that Stirling University manage this programme, and that is a real feather to it. And we've already heard it's a jewel in the crown, and I would certainly second that. In the current economic climate, programmes such as these are a major impact. And we know that while Scotland has a first-class sporting facilities, some of them are at risk across local authorities, and that needs to be talked about. Of course, universities play an important role in providing high-quality sports facilities, and I welcome the fact that Stirling had a new £20 million sports centre, which was opened back in 2020. But for many council and for many communities, swimming pools, leisure centres and athletic tracks are at risk. And in order for Scotland to keep that reputation as a leading sports nation, it's vitally important that young athletes have access to world-class facilities across Scotland. However, in the current climate, that is in real difficulty, Presiding Officer. So while we see the winning student programme 100 is in need of support, and as I said, I am the first to commend and congratulate everyone who's involved in it, because I do believe it does give and produces world-class athletes for Scotland, Presiding Officer. As I've said, Scotland has a long sporting nation and an excellent reputation going forward. Programmes such as these are key to maintaining that reputation. I have no doubt that the 500 scholarships that will be awarded through this programme up to 2028 will lead to countless amazing sporting achievements. So in conclusion, Presiding Officer, I would like to thank all those from the University of Stirling who have dedicated their time, their commitment and their passion to supporting these young individuals in their programmes, and wish everybody the success that all these talented athletes deserve. And I'm sure we will see many benefits from them from this programme as they go forward in the years to come. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Mr. Stewart. I now call Kenneth Gibson to be followed by Claire Baker. Around 4 minutes, Mr. Gibson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I too thank my colleague Keith Brown for bringing this topic to the Chamber today. As a Stirling University Economics graduate, I'm delighted to participate in this celebration of my alma mater, a place which holds such fond memories for me. It seems only weeks ago that I was careering around the campus and often venturing further afield, my huge Art Garfunkelstil mane straddled by the wind, enjoying the spectacular scenery Stirling and its surroundings have to offer. Sadly, my careering days are over, my curls almost gone. But as a former member of Stirling University Athletics Club, I share Keith Brown's pride at Stirling's rich sporting heritage, which continues to prosper under the expansion of the Winning Student 100 Scholarship, supporting 106 students in its first year across 28 sports. Scholarship students will play a pivotal role in retaining Scotland's Scottish talent on our home turf, And Stirling, of course, is Scotland's centre for sporting excellence, as we have already heard. The academic flexibility offered by the programme enables talented Scots to pursue sporting dual career pathways within our home nation, bypassing the dubious allure of the American college system or opportunities down south. This is important for remaining close to support networks and maintaining a consistent training environment, crucial for high-level athletic performance. And the £20 million investment in new sporting facilities opened in 2020 shows the commitment to sport in Stirling for many years to come. Moreover, by keeping our top athletes at home, we contribute to the economy, bolster national pride and reinforce our sporting identity. And by investing in the dual careers of our athletes, we foster a generation of educated and disciplined sports people. Recipients of the scholarship, such as Abby Kane and Rory Dixon from my own Cunningham North constituency, serve as inspiring role models for their peers and future generations. This is particularly significant for low-income, female or disabled athletes who remain underrepresented in sports. By witnessing the success of our scholarship athletes, they'll be more inclined to believe in their own ability to pursue a dual sporting career too. However, the expansion of the scholarship is not only an investment for the future, it also significantly improves the academic and athletic performance of our athletes today. Indeed, there's a plethora of evidence suggesting that students who participate in sports at university are less likely to drop out and overall attain more qualifications than their peers. A similar correlation has been identified with on-field performance, where athletes enrolled in further education demonstrate improved teamwork, discipline and self-regulation abilities. Crucially, the broadening of this programme will provide crucial assistance for athletes during their retirement and transition to life beyond sports. Public attention tends to focus solely on athletes at the zenith of their careers, while scant regard is given to their well-being and the intricacies of retiring from sports. Supporting athletes through university aids planning for the dark day when they must retire from competitive sport, facilitates adjustment to the labour market and enhances employment prospects. Beyond financial considerations, having accomplishments outside of sport means athletes are less likely to encounter psychological challenges and identity crisis upon retirement from competition. Presiding Officer, I congratulate those who have been involved in the winning Student 100 programme over the last 16 years. Their dedication and commitment has undoubtedly played a pivotal role in shaping the future of countless aspiring athletes. And I'd like to emphasise to young Scots that pursuing a career in sport need not come at the expense of academic or personal growth. With determination and support, they can excel in both realms, contributing to the rich tapestry of Scottish sporting excellence. The University of Stirling's contribution to Scottish sport is the pride of our nation. Well done to all who have been involved, and best of luck to those who are still to pass through the university doors in the coming years. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr Gibson. And I call Claire Baker. Around 4 minutes, Ms Baker.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'd like to start by thanking Keith Brown for bringing this debate to the Chamber. I am pleased to welcome the new funding for the new winning Students 100 Sports Scholarship Programme, to recognise the role of University of Stirling in running the scheme and to celebrate the success of the winning Students Programme since it was first established in 2008. The partnership between the Scottish Funding Council, Sport Scotland and the education sector is very welcome. Scotland's upcoming sporting heroes will see the benefit of this investment in them, and I hope that the support will have a significant impact on their sporting futures. It is also important to recognise that sporting excellence benefits Scotland as a whole, supporting our local and wider economies and Scotland's place on the international stage. We are, of course, in Olympic year, and this past weekend here in Scotland, we have seen many top athletes at the World Indoor Championship in Glasgow. As spectators, we can enjoy the competition and the achievement we see on those stages, but we recognise that behind it, there are many years of training and hard work striving towards sporting excellence. But that training and hard work often goes alongside a day job, or for younger participants, alongside their education. Being able to balance that is no mean feat, which is why this partnership between the Scottish Funding Council, Sport Scotland and the further and higher education sector should be recognised. The involvement of Sport Scotland is a positive addition and reflects the commitment of the sporting and education bodies to working together to support our student athletes. For those who are looking to balance their studies with sporting commitments, the programme not only provides financial support, but by working with colleges and universities, ensures that students are able to balance their training and competition with the demands of their courses. They make sure that additional support is in place, like academic flexibility, which is key to allowing student athletes to pursue their dual interests. The funding from the programme can help in covering the cost of travel, not just for competitions, but also to and from training facilities. The additional funding, which is available in the current round for athletes coming from areas of high deprivation, is to be welcomed. I am pleased to hear that the newly branded programme has already awarded 106 scholarships for 23-24, encompassing Olympians, Paralympians, European and World Champions. These include the current Olympic curling champion, Hayley Duff, a student at a University of Stirling graduate. Members will be aware of my interest in protecting curling facilities at the Dewar Centre in Perth and its role in providing a number of medals for Scotland on the European and world stages, including the girls' event won by Scotland's Junior Championships team led by Robin Munro at the European Junior Curling Tour at Dewar Centre in January last year. This team included the former Perth Academy student Hayley Wilkie-Milne, who grew up training at the Perth Link. The importance of investment in competitions and the provision of facilities go hand in hand. The recent success of teams at the Perth Masters, where curlers of all generations, from new beginners to Olympians, competed, helped demonstrate that. The original winning students programme saw over 1,700 scholarships awarded during its first phase of funding, including to middle and long distance runner Laura Muir, who was raised in Milnathorpe. She successfully balanced studying for a degree as a vet with the rigours of working towards her European title and Olympic silver. Laura competed in the recent World Indoor Championships at the Commonwealth Arena in Glasgow alongside Josh Kerr and Gemma Rieke. Her successes are a great example of what the programme supports and an inspiration to current participants. I am looking forward to seeing the positive impacts of this updated programme on the lives and careers of the participating student athletes from my region of Mid Scotland and Fife and across Scotland. I want to express my best wishes for continued success to the young athletes who have benefited from this programme and thank the network of universities and colleges, stakeholders and organisations that are involved and particularly recognise the huge contribution made by Stirling University. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms Baker. I now call on Graham Day to respond to the debate. Minister, around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you. Let me begin by thanking Keith Brown for bringing this motion to Parliament this afternoon and to those members from across the Chamber who have contributed, especially so Kenneth Gibson, who I think teased us with his contribution. I think I can speak for the Chamber when I say we really enjoy sight of the photographs of that Art Garfunkel look he sported during his time at Stirling University. We often hear about the power of sport and the positive and valuable contribution that sport and physical activity has to personal, community and national well-being in Scotland. I know how much store I set by heading to the golf course, for example, for the benefit of my own mental and physical health, even though all too often that activity does very little for my blood pressure or indeed fulfil a pledge I made to cut down on my use of unparliamentary language outside of this place. But to be serious, sport also has the power to unite, and this is particularly evident when you witness the passion we Scots show as a nation supporting our sporting superstars. Scotland continues to produce world-class athletes competing over many different disciplines on the international stage, be it at the Commonwealth Games, the Olympics or Paralympics, or international events like the World Indoor Athletics Championships, which took place in Glasgow last week. Our athletes deliver outstanding performances. And whilst we witness their success, it would be remiss if we did not acknowledge, as Claire Baker did, that these successes require years of dedication and sacrifice. The level of commitment required from young athletes to develop and progress in sport is so impressive, and it's essential that a positive pathway exists for individuals who wish to pursue both sporting and academic excellence. We are committed to ensuring that all students in Scotland have access to the best possible support and that those that need it most are supported. I want to ensure we continue to do all we can to give our athletes and our young people the help they need. And that's why I'm delighted to see the launch of the Winning Students 100 Scholarship. The programme is a true cross-sector collaboration of Scotland's sport and higher education bodies, which will assist our young athletes to find the right balance between training, their studies and other commitments. The partnership between Sport Scotland, the Funding Council and Stirling University will build on the foundations and successes of the original Winning Students programme, and with funding secured until 2028, the numbers of athletes supported will continue to grow. As a sports fan, I've watched previous Winning Students recipients do amazing things on the world stage. Athletes like Duncan Scott, who in Tokyo became the first Team GB athlete ever to win four medals in a single game. So Laura Muir, as others have noted, another former recipient and now firmly established as one of the world's top middle distance runners. Whilst training to be a vet at the University of Glasgow, the Winning Students Programme provided Laura with scholarship funding to help her achieve both her sporting and academic goals. And I'm grateful to Keith Brown for reminding us that Eilish McColgan too was a beneficiary, Eilish having been born and raised in Carnoustie in my Angus South constituency. The programme also gave paracyclist Karen Dart the opportunity to change her academic focus and to get advice about the direction of her studies as a scholar athlete. As part of the programme, Karen was given flexibility when it came to studying and competing. And there are so many other former recipients that I could mention who've gone on to be successful at their sport, and in some cases becoming World, Olympic or Commonwealth Championship. As Alexander Stewart noted, 106 scholarships have already been awarded for 23-24 across 28 different sports, and I have no doubt that many of the current recipients will become our superstars of tomorrow. Those receiving scholarships include athletes like Megan Keith, who's already setting European age level records, and Grace Reid, Scotland's most decorated diver. Both are prime examples of world-class student athletes pursuing excellence in and out of the classroom. And we remain committed to the principle that access to education should be based on the ability to learn, not the ability to pay. All students, no matter their background, should have an equal chance of entering and succeeding in higher education. I therefore particularly welcome the additional funding available to student athletes originating from areas of high deprivation. This can make a real difference, particularly with the flexibility of scholarship funding to be spent on a number of support services, from student accommodation to competition fees and sports equipment. Sporting experiences in colleges and universities play a key role in the development of young people in their early sporting lives and are a vital part of building their competence and confidence in sport. Last year saw the successful launch of College Active Campus Network, a groundbreaking initiative aimed at promoting health and well-being among students in higher education. This exciting new partnership delivered between Sport Scotland and College of Scotland and alongside Scottish Student Support will help put sport and physical activity at the centre of college life by giving students across the country the opportunity to get active, significantly benefiting the physical and mental well-being of participants. I'm sure all this year's winning students recipients will be fantastic ambassadors for sport and act as role models within colleges and universities, encouraging others to participate and be physically active. Presiding Officer, winning students has a proven contribution to the performance sports system in Scotland, combining the power of education and sport in a truly distinctive way and as a key ingredient to success. I can't wait to see and hear about all the future sporting and academic achievements of future alumni of Winning Students 100. Again, I want to thank Keith Brown for securing the debate, which has provided us the opportunity to celebrate not only the launch of Winning Students 100, but also the achievements of Scotland's young athletes. Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Minister. I think we all look forward to seeing the photos of Kenneth Gibson, who, like Art Garfunkel, has dedicated his career to building bridges over troubled waters. And with that, that concludes the debate, and I close this meeting of Parliament.